Hey guys, welcome back to another Rogue Moves episode in my summer car. And let's make ours blue again. Okay, so we're going to get back right into it. So we left off with not a lot of money, but I did buy a bunch of beer, which is sitting out here. My car fell down by the looks of it. So I left it up on the tractor. I'm going to clean up a little bit, put this stuff in the fridge. That way it's where it needs to be, so I remember where it is when I need it. What are those again? Brake fluid. Let's put those on the counter. I wonder if you can drink brake fluid in this game. Seems like something they'd probably let you do, eh? So, I was left in the comments that there are some ways to cheat in this game, but I'm going to not do them because you really can't anymore. It seems that the console's been taken out. Salt. Well, it's wash. So you can't just jump into the console and throw some cheats in. But that's fine. I don't really want to cheat anyways. So we'll speed through this real quick and then get back into the game. And there we go. So let's go in here and turn on our sauna thingy. Because from what I remember, this is the only way to get clean, because for some reason they don't have a working shower, which is kind of dumb. How do I pee again? Player controls. Urinate. Control. K and P. Why did they do that? P. Hitchhike. That sounds like fun. Anything O? No. We'll just change, push the O. Okay. So let's go back. Oh, we don't need those. So we'll bring this back in here. Get it ready. Okay, here we go. Then we'll, what can we do? I'm trying to figure out what we can do. Let's see here. Oh yeah, there's the pointless thing. Hunger is getting up there, so let's eat something. Come on, fridge, close. Okay. Yeah, there's all my beer. So let's get this out of the way. There we go. I would like to move the car, but I don't want to push it, because I'm pretty sure it won't let me push it very easily. It goes through your fatigue quite a lot, I'm guessing. Oh, it's not too bad, I guess. Huh, there we go. That was okay. Oops. I did mean to urinate. Okay. I wonder, can we... Oh my god, we're so slow. I wonder if you can put stuff under the car to hold it up. I know I've put, I've personally put wheels under my car to hold my car up before. I wonder if I can put it on a beer. No, I don't want to put it on a beer. Do I even have wheels? Oh, I do. Oh, they're tiny, though. Well, let's give it a shot. Put one right there. Put them under the front. Because that's where we're going to end up doing most of the work today. Whoa. Whatever. Okay, let's see if that works. Where's the spot on the jack? Let me use the jack. Huh, that works. Perfect. So jack up the other side of the car. Oh, then I wonder if I can just jack up the back. Oh, it doesn't work. I know I can lift it with the forklift, so maybe I'll just do that. Jack her back up. Let's just see if I can get the forklift under it. The last attempt didn't end too well. Let's see how this one goes. Let's get these tigers out of the way. It's freaking flies, man. Oh, it's going up through the car floor. I need it in further than that so I don't break it with the forklift. Okay, let's see if we can get under that with the forklift. God, how do I drive the forklift again? Okay. Where's the handbrake on this thing again? Diff lock. Oh, it's right here. How do I put it in gear? I don't remember how to play. Oh. No, that's the hand throttle. I don't remember how to play. So I'm in neutral. Oh, what was it again? That's it, I'll just look. Brakes, clutch, hand, brake. G and B. Presume. B. Let's see how that is. Okay, that should be good. I just gotta lower the forks more. Oh, wrong way. Wait, where was that? That was the right way. Was it? It's hard to tell. Oh, I gotta get in. That's going up. Is that low enough? Getting there. There. Probably not safe leaving a car in gear. Okay, so. Hard to see over the front of that thing. It's okay. How's that? That should be good, actually. I can go a little bit further. Or if I put it in. What gear was I in again? I think I was in 4-1 high. Come on. Oh, I'm in 1 low. Okay, there we go. Put it in neutral. Aha. Oh, really? It's lifting up this thing. There we go. Oh. Crap. What if I can... Actually, I might just be able to push it over. That would be pretty spectacular if I just could. So let's see if I can. Oh, it's going. It's going. Keep going. Okay, it's probably resting on the forks now then. Yeah, so let's bring the forks back down and then go back up. There we go. Let's see where it's sitting on the forks. Actually, we could probably just push it the rest of the way on if... By the looks of it, we need to. Doesn't look like I can. So let's put those away. Maybe you drive forward a little more. Might get under it. It's taking me almost like 10 minutes just to get this stupid thing up in the air. Oh well. Let's put it back in neutral and give her a try. Not working. Oops. Starting to run low on fuel too. Turn the ignition off until we're ready for it. I wonder if I can. I wonder if that's a thing. I wonder if I can lift it up with this and push it over. Actually, that seems to be working. Just inch it over, inch by using the jack glitch. did I just do it? I think I just did it. Let's see where we're at. Oh, I need to go a little further. Let's see where we're, how we're doing there. Oh, so close. I want it right up against the fork, so the forks are under as far as they can go. Don't judge me. What if I can push it now? Doesn't look like it. Nope, still can't push it. Should turn the lights off on that thing. Hopefully it doesn't die on me. So it seems to be on the forks anyway, so we'll see what we see if it'll work now. It's too bad the this doesn't work unless it's running. Oh, does it? Let's turn the lights off. Don't need the lights on. Yes, perfect. Not perfect. Crap. Actually, we can work with this as long as it... It's gonna keep sliding, isn't it? And eventually we'll fall over. Yeah, look, it's moving. I wonder if we kind of cheat the system here. Oh, is it not moving now? Did I reach an equilibrium? I'm gonna put this right next to the tire. That way the tire can't go any further. Okay, cool. Let's see what, oh, I can't even... What order does this go in again? Crap. So, oh, it's gonna fall again. Crap. Actually, I wonder if I bring it down a little bit if it won't be too bad. Come in. Come on. Get in. That should hopefully be okay. Get out of the way, door. Still slipping. Stupid car. Oops. Anyways, got my anger out. actually, that might not be such a bad thing. We'll just try rotating it. Come on, door, go away. Well, maybe I'll just pick it from the front. Because I gotta put the subframe on. Come on, car. Go. Don't tell me it's stuck now. Do I have to restart just in case? Let's go through the car. Come on. Do I have to inch it with my friggin' thing again? Maybe I'll just restart this video. It's been a pain in the butt. I love game physics. So let's go this way. Why can't I push you? I was able to push you before. Okay, anyways, let's get back to work. So jack up the front end. Guess we'll do this the long way. Wonder how high I can get with the jack. Why aren't you letting me get anything? Shouldn't fall off the jack at least, right? It's getting awfully close. That's probably as high as it needs to go. Anyway, so I'm gonna jump inside here to get rid of that dirtiness. Oh, it does hit. I was gonna say that's so close. I really just need to have this shower work. Like, turn the shower on and pull the thingy and then go for a shower. Let's get rid of our thirst. It's the easiest way. Close you should be up over 100 now, yep. Somehow that makes us cleaner. Oh, I missed. Sometimes it just seems to not work. It's weird. I might as well go all the way, eh? Ah, I missed again. Oh, what the heck? And we're clean. Good enough. So we'll put the spoon down. Let's go fill this back up. Put you down. Pee in you. Doesn't fill it up. See what the bucket doesn't like overflow and stuff like that. But I guess that's like all stuff that's I'm just being nitpicky at that point, eh? Close the door. Don't need that door open either. Or that door. That seems to actually take away quite a bit of the humming. Which is nice. Okay. So we need a wrench. I think bring our wrenches. Oh, you can hear it through the wall. Bring our wrenches out. I have to open this thing again. Come on. Oh, yeah, that's right. Like that. So, can you even see sizes? I don't see sizes. Grab that one for now. So we're gonna start with subframe. Subframe, subframe, subframe. Which way does it go? That'd be the front, because that's where the rad supports go. Yeah. We got it, can't get underneath. It's the wrong size. Bigger. Those should actually be pretty big. Nope. Can't even see this one. Can I get any? You can't go any higher, can you? That car's just gonna fall. I wonder what size it is. Smaller? It's one thing I hate about this game, is trying to pick the right size. In Car Mechanic Simulator, you just always have the right size on you. There we go. Tight. Oh, I wonder if it'll be easier to push with it on wheels. Maybe that's why I couldn't push it. Okay, let's try to push it again. See if I can get it over. Oh. Oh, crap. I left the freaking tractor going. Probably almost out of gas by now. Sorry, almost out of diesel. Eh, not too bad. Temperature's still down. Still in reverse, too. That's not good. See where we're at, maybe we'll just pick it up with a forklift if that doesn't glitch, which it probably will, because games are fun like that. So let's go forward a little bit more still. Yeah, let's try that. We can just turn it off because we don't need it. It's on one fork. That should be good enough. See if I can lift it up a little bit higher, make it easier for us to get under. Is there like a hydraulics button? No. Okay. Graphical wheel steering help, steering non-linear, high speed steering rate, force feedback. Oh, I guess that's if you've got like a controller with your, what do you call it, thing. There we go, that should be good. It's gonna be nighttime soon, already tired. guess you really have to eat like once a day. Oh, okay, good. It's not in the way of the door. Just gotta crouch underneath the car to get to it. So, let's grab the steering rack. Steering column. There's steering rack. Got dirt and dust. Can you paint stuff like that? I want to make it look clean. That sucks. Can I paint my air filter box? Well, you should be able to paint that. Nope. How do you use the spray paint then? I'll have to figure that out, I guess. Wait, pull the choke on your car. What is this, the 1980s? Okay, steering rack. Oh my god, that'll make it so much easier. You should be right. Whoa. Too high. Towing hook? Oh my god. Oh my god. What am I doing? You can tow stuff now. I wonder if I can glitch it through the tractor. Hook it on so it doesn't fall off. How long can I make this? Oh, wait. Oh. Wait, what did that say? Oh, there is a tow hook. There. That shouldn't fall off at least. Be nice if I could grab that steering rack, though. Oh, there we go. Oh, it goes back here. I see. Oh, of course, it's a different size. Just grab the whole thing here. This is probably a pretty long episode. I got nothing better to do right now, so we'll take our time. And what are we at for recording time? Half an hour-ish. So. Smaller, yes. I guess I can just stand in the engine bay now. It's like that's when I find out that it's not recording. Yay, good for me. Okay, those are all tight. Back to my tools here. Okay. What do we need next? We need steering column. Yes, I am kind of using a tutorial for this because, like, let's face it, I'm not that good. Granted, I could probably do a real car, but this is far from a real car. I figured there'd be one on the bottom. Is there any inside the car? Really? It hooks over? I mean, sure, if that's what it wants to do. Steering column, wishbones. That's the suspension. Look at those fronts. Those are trailing arms, those are rears. Wishbone. Front right. So that'd be passenger side. Boop. Those should be pretty big. Watch, they're gonna be absolutely tiny. And I'll be totally wrong. Like I always am. Oh no, okay, good, that's not too bad. See if we can get this car built before we have to go do stuff like chop wood and stuff. Okay, go grab the other one. Putting bolts in. There's no nut on it though, which is, I don't know if I would trust that. Okay, and that one's in, that one's in, that one's in. Okay. Wishbone spindles. The front spindles. Those will be those ones. Let's do front left first, because we're right here. Wait, wait. Yeah, there we go. That's pretty big. Bigger. There we go. There, I guess the top's not in yet, so. Go grab the other one. Oop, go underneath. Gotta be semi-realistic about it. The bolt does actually seem to turn, because if you look at it, it actually has a line right down the middle where the right there, where it doesn't quite line up from the texture being put on it. Come on, bolt. Is that supposed to be, is that all the way in? I guess it is, because that one looks the same. How many ugga duggas does it take? What's the torque spec? Steering rods. Those would be tie rods. Front right, front left. Put the tie rods in. Duh, idiot. It goes the other way. I swear I saw a check mark. I swear. Watch, it doesn't actually go the other way. Totally does. Called it. You guys didn't have any faith in me. So look, those are, that's, that one's totally not tight. How's the other side look? Because glitching can be a good thing sometimes. See my loose ass bolts. See that? Those two don't look tight at all. So let's tighten this up. See that? That is not tight. What is it? It's not even attaching to anything. I hope I'm doing this in the right order. Let me go down a couple of sizes here and see if I can remember what size that was. For these bolts. There's no way that, yeah, I called it. That was not tight. Like, look at the gap. Oh, I couldn't imagine. Well, hopefully my car passes safety inspection. So that's the one thing, is after you're all done, you have to get it inspected. So we'll see how well that goes. Put the side up. Oh, I do have it. Grab my big wrench, which was, I think, that one. Yep. See, it doesn't go into anything. It just doesn't go in it. It doesn't go anywhere. I'm gonna guess it's supposed to go in the top part. Well, I guess we'll see. What would I be missing? There's nothing missing from the front end. What are those? Hubcaps? Steering. Brakes. Rad. Floor jack, really? Fuel tank pipe? The fuel tank? Battery? Well, I guess once we get it going, and then I got the engine all assembled. I wonder if I can paint my door pink. Oops. Oh yeah, I forgot that I dropped a sway bar in here. Oh no, that's exhaust. I thought that was a sway bar. Come on, upstairs. Upstairs. Come on. Holy crap. Okay. So. Spindles, steering rods, disc brakes. So we'll actually grab the discs with the built-in hubs. That's fancy. Must be a Honda. So that should be a big one. It's bigger than that. There we go. Okay. Grab the other one. That's one thing about this game is there's two levels of crouch, and the lowest crouch, and even the second lowest crouch, you can't run. But if you're walking, if you're up at the highest point, you can run. You just need to have an always run function. That bolt is going into nothing. There's nothing there. Half shafts. Half shafts are the... Half shafts are for the rear, aren't they? Wait, what am I thinking of? Half shafts. With the... Yeah, those are for the rear. Oh, the car's front wheel drive. That's right. Duh, I'm so used to friggin' rear wheel drive. You know, real man's car. Why can't I move? What am I caught on? Oh my god. Go faster. I'm gonna quickly, zoom through this part and go to the bed, because my fatigue's not all the way up, but for some reason I'm moving very slow. Oh, he's speeding up. There we go. That's weird. So yeah, not quite made yet. Put the half shafts in. Those usually go in after a motor. I guess we do that later, I guess. Come on, let me mount you in a completely non-sexual way. Does that go on? Obviously doesn't bolt to that side. Should basically be just like that. Wait. That side goes in the motor. Did this have a side? No, it's just a half shaft. Where's that bolt up to? I'm so confused. Do I need to take the bolt out? Oh, maybe that is what I have to do. I tighten that too prematurely. Yep. Hey, I had a check mark. Don't do that to me. Yeah, see, now that bolt actually has something to go into. So I'll probably have that issue later on with the tie rods, because there's no upper knuckle. That's weird. Where is the other one? It's weird that they're both the same length. I never see that. Totally just pick that up backwards. That's apparently in all the way. Okay. Put the struts in. Oh, those are gonna bolt up to the top too. Front left. Rotate. Look, it's automatically tight. Nice. Yeah, look at that. Perfect guess. First time. Oh, there's four. I'm trying to remember what kind of car this was supposed to be. Kind of want one now. I know how to put one together, so, you know, why not? Fatigue is getting a little high. Gonna have to go to bed soon. Summer reminds me of putting the suspension in my, I had a Nissan 240SX and did it in my brother-in-law's garage on the floor. Just me and him. That's a big nut. Actually, I've got a pretty good scar on my hand. On the my index finger knuckle of my right hand that I got from doing the exhaust on that same Nissan 240SX. Struts, steering rod adjust. I'm unsure of what that means. It adjusts the steering rod. Which I'm gonna guess is the in the car. She uses a 14. So 10, 12, 13, 14. That's my guess, anyways. Oh my god, you have to adjust your own freaking steering? Is that what that nut is there for? Uh-oh. Okay, good. It didn't fall on me and kill me. Where did it go? Might have to take a minute break here and figure out how the heck to adjust the steering. What size is the 14 mil? You know what? I could probably... Oh my god. Oh my god. This is gonna suck. You have to eyeball this. Okay. So I want to eyeball it so it's kind of straight-ish. Oh, I can just climb up here and tighten those ones. It's hard to eyeball this when you can't really see it. And you don't really know what straight is. Always do this afterwards. There's no reason to do that now. It's pretty stupid to do that now. Trailing arms, coil springs, shock absorbers. So now I have to do the back of the car. So let's unattach my... move the tow rope. Can I attach the tow rope to the back of the car? So I can just drag it out. Oh my god, I can. Okay, cool. Let's just do that then. So let's hit the hay, get that fatigue meter down, go at this again tomorrow. So let's see here, go in here, go to the bed. It's too bad there's like nothing in these drawers. Sleep. Is that a Garfield? What does that say? Belfield? It's totally Garfield. That's awesome. We need to go to this. GT Tour. Oh my god, that'd be so much fun. That's a BMW E30. Hot concept video horror. Gotta change these posters. Like the one in the garage. I don't know if you've noticed, but can I plug the phone? Oh my god, I can. Let's go take care of some issues here first. Let's get rid of our thirst. Yeah, you can basically pee anywhere, which is kind of stupid, but... there's no drain. Why do they have a shower but no drain? I'll go take care of that hunger. Yeah, that's right, I bought mosquito spray. And then we'll close that door too, because we don't need it open. Should we just eat another thing of macaroni? That'd be enough. Yes. Raise my thirst up a little bit, but that's okay. We'll drink a beer later. If we need it. Okay, let's, yeah, because I got tons of beer. Slam the car back down. Okay, here we go. Can we enter driving mode? Actually, I don't want to enter driving mode right now. Let's hook up the tow rope. Oh my god, this is the best thing ever. Wish I knew about this sooner. Let's see if we can pull it around. Hopefully that can happen, and this doesn't end up a disaster and end up on my roof or something. Okay, let's enter driving mode. Go into reverse. Hello. Forks all the way down? Yes. Okay. Beep. Beep. They're not under the car, are they? Let's detach the rope. To back the tractor up a little bit more. See if we can sneak underneath. Oh, I am stuck inside of it. I am actually stuck inside of the car. Uh-oh. This sucks. What if I can push it off? Probably not, because that would be too easy. Oh, crap. Guess we'll cross that bridge when we get to it. The park and brake out. It's stuff in the van. What did I have in the van again? Diesel, gas, oil. What's that? Coolant? What's that one? Oh, I only have one entrance. They should make this game multiplayer. Could you imagine how much fun that would be? Anyways. I can now tighten these, so I might as well. What, did I wake up too early? Pretty small. Smaller or bigger than that one? So I'm hoping Tim gets some gaming out, because Tim now has high-speed internet, so we should hopefully get, because he's moved into his own house, so we should be able to get some videos of me and him playing, because me and him haven't played too much lately, him moving and everything, growing up. Okay, that one's tight. The car's slipping slightly, which is fine. Oh, can I attach the tow rope to the van? I don't think so. Oh, I totally can. Okay, so I have a way of pulling that apart. I'm gonna attach the tow rope to the back of the van and pull it off, but might as well, finish up with the back end before I do that. Oops. Perfect. So we need to do the trailing arms. Wait, I want the other one first because it's I already have it. What does it bolt to? Where's it supposed to bolt? It's gonna bolt to nothing, isn't it? It's gonna be. That is the weirdest friggin' thing I've ever seen. Is it really supposed to be like that? Oh my god, that's so weird! I would never trust my life to that. Not real life, anyways. Video games are another thing. I was thinking about streaming this on Twitch today, but I don't know. It just seems a little late. Doesn't kind of seem like a waste of time. Just for today, anyways. Maybe I'll, if I get some time tomorrow, we'll throw up a quick stream, get a little further into the game. There we go. Picking the right size friggin' wrench sucks. Go get the other side. Throw some drum brakes on. My god, that's just... I can honestly say I've never seen anything like that in my entire life. That just seems so wrong. Look, see, those have nuts. I still gotta do, like, the fuel lines and the brake lines. Drill arms. The coil spring. That'll just go in here, probably. Somewhere, like this. Yeah, right there, on that perch. Oh my god, is that bent? It's got a bend to it. Oh, that reminds me of, I used to work with a guy at, way back in the day at Walmart, and he had a car, and it was lowered, aftermarket style with, cut springs, and he went over a set of train tracks and lost his springs on the back of the car. So he just went to the junkyard, bought new springs. He didn't even care what they were out of it. Then he cut them and put them back in. Just goes to show you can't... not everybody's trustworthy with vehicles. But yeah, I think he only paid like $500 for the car, so I don't think he cared too much. Tim was here, so I'd have somebody to talk to. My god, what is this, the size of these things? How big are they? That's pretty big, actually. Damn it. Usually that means you're close, I find. You get that. I honestly wish these just had sizes written on them. It's not going to be the biggest one. I don't think I've used this ratchet, this wrench yet. I wonder, can I bring one of my tires over? And put this on top of the tires? Yes, okay, good. That way I can just stay half crouched. Oh, it's not high enough. That's the car glitchy tire. That should be fine. Come on. Like whipped it. Oh, getting a little thirsty. Gonna have to crack open. Damn it! Crack open a beer soon. Oh, fucking stupid game. Well, that's why I'm pressing the throw button. Duh, idiot. I forgot that if you right click, it throws it. No wonder I was having such a problem before trying to get those tires to line up. There we go. That should be better. Let's go crack a beer. Rory, can you pick up your empties? Is that a thing? Oh, you can. Sweet. I'm gonna go throw this in the garbage. Oh, and I missed, of course. Go figure. See if we can get it from here. Oops. Let's go inside for a quick second here. So guys, we're going to call this here, and we'll catch you in the next episode. Thanks. Bye.